Good morning, everyone.
My name is Lakita Watson, and I am the Director of Parks and Recreation, and I will be your MC for today's wonderful event. It is such a wonderful occasion to come together to celebrate such awesome young people that have spent this last summer with the City of Suffolk, helping us accomplish our goals and to actually add to our wonderful city. I would like to introduce or recognize a couple of individuals that are in the room. I will start with Councilman Lou Ward. Our Deputy City Manager, Scott Mills. Our City Manager, whom you'll be hearing from, Mr. Patrick Roberts. And if I can get all of our department heads to please stand to be recognized, Mr. Gary Jones. And of course, to all of our honorees, thank you all for taking the time out this morning to come and be with us, and to the parents for your constant support. Now I will call to the podium our City Manager, Mr. Patrick Roberts, to give congratulatory remarks.
Thank you, Lakita. Good morning, everybody. I'm very glad to be with you this morning. I'm also, again, very glad to be joined by Councilman Lou Ward of the Nansemond Borough. We're always very grateful to our City Council for their continued support and celebration of the next leaders of our city, and that's the youth, particularly those who have spent so much time with us this summer. So thank you. I want to begin my remarks by addressing the young folks who've worked with us all summer long. I just want to say to you, on behalf of all of the employees of the people of the City of Suffolk, thank you very much for working with us this summer. Thanks for bringing your talent, your time, your energy, and your efforts. And we want to really tell you how much we appreciate all that you've learned and all that you've turned around and applied to our work here in Suffolk. I hope that you've learned something from the time that you've spent. It's very encouraging to us. Some of the days we have are very good ones. We make a lot of progress. And some days we just hold the line and try not to fall a little farther behind. We've got our challenges, but many times we find ourselves celebrating our success. And that's what today is about. So for all of your efforts and achievements this summer and all throughout the year, congratulations to you. To the many department heads, managers, and supervisors, thank you for your continued leadership. Thank you for being mentors, setting examples, not only for the folks who work with us this summer, but throughout all of the community. It's through your leadership that we will continue to build upon this great city and make it even more great place to live, work, visit, worship, and play. Thank you again. I hope as we start the school year, we turn anew to new chapters, new exciting adventures, and look forward to the remainder of the year. Godspeed, congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Manager. This program was started about 7 years ago. We've watched the growth. So many of you, I hope, will come back and become permanent employees with the City of Suffolk. For many of us, started right where you are. I myself started in what was called the STOP program many years ago. Don't look like it, but sometimes I feel like it. Many years ago, I was a custodian at John F. Kennedy when it was a high school. I know some of y'all don't remember when it was a high school, but there are a few of us in the room that do. And that experience was definitely a blessing for me to allow me the opportunity to see what work is about. So we hope that you take these lessons with you and you've learned something. I always believe that, and it's something that my granddaddy used to say, is that if you don't work, you don't eat. So I'm gonna need for you all to take this seriously. This is an example of something you can put on your resume, on your applications, and this is not the end, this is the beginning of your next endeavors. I would like now to take a moment to pause and recognize our two other council members that came into the room, our Vice Mayor, Mr. Leroy Bennett, and Mr. Roger Fawcett from the Sleepy Hole Borough. Thank you for joining us. Your support is always appreciated. Now for what one part, of course, what most of us came to do is to prepare to eat. I believe in a saying, be ye also ready. So we had to change the program a little bit and ask one of my team members to come forward and give us grace, Mr. Dwight Druitt.
Thank you. Good morning. Let us bow for the grace. Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless the food we're about to receive for the nourishment of our body. Heavenly Father, we ask that you would just feed the hungry everywhere. Heavenly Father, we ask that you would bless this food, Heavenly Father, and we ask you to bless the hand that fix this food. These and all the blessings we ask in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Dwight. With that, we will go ahead and get started with our breakfast, and I'll look for direction from our Hilton staff. I think that we're going to do, is this a buffet or served? So this is a buffet. We'll start, of course, with our head table, and then we will start, then go ahead with our middle table so that you can go out into the hallway and start your meal. Thank you. Good morning again. I hope you all have enjoyed your breakfast. We're going to go ahead and get started with the remainder of the program. We are excited to be able to recognize all of our young people for their accomplishments this summer. And of course, it always makes me feel great to have such a wonderful team member in Mrs. Rakita Fofana. She works tirelessly to make sure that all of the interns are properly trained. She communicates with them on a regular basis as it relates to their evaluations. She runs after the supervisors to make sure they're doing what they need to do. And she works closely with social services to make sure that they get paid. Rakita is definitely a rare gem, and I hate to put her on the spot, but I believe in giving people their flowers while they're still living. And she just loves kids. She loves each and every one of these young people. So it's always wonderful to see her work so hard. So if you can join me with giving her a round of applause as she comes to this table.
Good morning, everyone. First, I would like to give honor to everyone. That honor is due our head officials, city council members, vice mayor. I know Ms. Watson already addressed you, but I did want to do that again. I want to start out by first thanking her. She is my direct supervisor, and I am beyond appreciative for the continuous support that she provides me as I do this program and every other aspect of my job. Giving her some flowers back and letting her know that she is truly, truly, truly appreciated because she has my back. If it's something happening and I'm thinking, okay, this might blow up, she's like, let me know what we need to do, who I need to call, where we need to go. So I appreciate her because she helps me help make the program a success. So again, I do thank you. I would next like to start out by thanking my HR representatives.
Yes.
They come in the beginning, they help me with paperwork. They help me with, God forbid, but when discipline issues arise, they are there to support me in all of those aspects. They make sure that everything is done so that, again, they can be paid, they can be processed properly. It can count as a real work experience, and for that, I am appreciative. Ms. Angela and Ms. Carrie, if you guys could come forward, and Mr. William will give you guys just a small token of our appreciation. I don't see my finance ladies in the room, but Ms. Charlotte and Ms. Irene, they're the ladies in finance that many of you have helped to deal with, whether you had to go back and take your direct deposit or if there were issues with paychecks, pay cards, whatever it might have been. Those are the ladies that kind of helped us out with that, and I do want to give them a thank you as well. Apparently, they weren't able to make it, but I'm still appreciative of them. Next, I would like to thank my department heads that were able to attend. I thank you for allowing us to be in your department. Not all departments are willing, and then there are just some who aren't able. But for those of you that allow us to do it and allow the people under you to have the youth, I appreciate you. The supervisors can't do it without you. You guys, you're the day-to-day. I work hard, but you guys work harder. And I do not take your work and your efforts, any of it, for granted. I know that it gets rough sometimes. I know that sometimes they are knuckleheads. I know sometimes they don't call you, they come late. I know that you deal with so much with dealing with multiple personalities, because some of you have many youth. You don't have just one. I am so grateful to you. You hang in there with me year after year, even when it's tough, even when you're glad today is the last day, you still come back the next year. I appreciate you so, so, so very much. I'm going to go down the list. I want you guys to come forward. We have just a small token of appreciation that we want to give you for all of the hard work that you have done this year with the youth. I apologize if I leave off any names. We tried to have you sign in so that we could make sure we recognize all of you that were here. So we'll start with Amy Miller. Byron Lawrence. Charlie Holcomb. Stanley Skinner. Darnell Lee. Dean Adams. Dwight Druitt. Jean Weaver. Gwendolyn Marshall. Janice Myrick. Jasmine Clark. Jason Jones. Janetta Williams. JJ Stevens. Joe Harris. Lori Brittle. Lisa Barnett. Tamara Mabry. Travell Allman. Veronica Thomas. Felicia Turner on behalf of Vicki Smith. Vidal Wilkins. Virgil Wiggins. Zella Raspberry. Angelica Scott. Penny Stubbs. Ronnie White, and Andre Ingram. Shante Bynum. Did I omit anybody? Again, I would like to thank you all so, so much for all of your dedication, all of the work that you put in with the youth, all of the training that you have provided them over the course of the summer. You are truly appreciated, and I look forward to working with each and every one of you again next year. And last but certainly not least, I would like to recognize the youth participants of the program. You guys make it all worth it. Yes, you guys can be knuckleheads sometimes, but you guys can also be amazing. You guys make it happen. You come, you dedicate yourselves, you commit yourselves. When you don't have a ride, you find a way. You worry somebody until they get you where you gotta go. You readjust your schedules. You make time for what you need to make time for. You guys are truly appreciated. We have lost some youth for various reasons, some who have already gone off to college, some who play high school sports and their seasons have already started. We have some who are still here that are actually gonna still leave to go to college later in the week. We have some who have since working here gained employment. We have others that we're hoping to soon get employment. We are excited for all of the opportunities that are going to be afforded to each and every one of you. I have made it clear from the very first day of orientation to you guys that I'm here for you. Nothing changes. I'll still be here on 6th Street, same phone number, same building. Always available to you, no matter what it is that you need assistance with, whether it's your school stuff, your work stuff, whatever should arise for you, I will be there. You just let me know. I have made it my business when I see most of you to try to say, what's next? What are you doing? What's your next goal? Are you going to school? Are you in school? Are you going to get a job? Where you working at? Do you play sports? Can I come see you? Do you get time? I'll be there. Nothing changes because the job has ended. I'll be there. You guys call me. I'll be your biggest fan. I'll be your resource. Whatever you need me to be, you just call me and let me know. I want to give you guys a token of my appreciation as well. So we'll call you forward and Mr. William will give you those. Again, I appreciate you guys because you all make it possible. Mark Baker. Tatiana Bayman. Quante Bayman. Quanasia Bowden. Khadijah Edgehill. Alexis Goodman. Alexis Godwin. Kenneth Harden. Hannah Huggins. Armand Jacobs. Dewan Jacobs. Ellery Jefferson. Clarence Jennings. Dejanay Johnson. Artasia Knight. Percy Mayo. Ashira McLean. Devon McCory. Jenna Mitchell. Alexis Outlaw. Kalasia Parker. Jasmine Douglas. Trevor Price. Ramad Wright. Did I omit anyone? Again, I would like to thank you all for all of your hard work over the course of the summer. You guys are truly, truly appreciated. Again, if there's ever anything that I can be of assistance to you guys with, please don't hesitate to let me know. And I apologize, parents, family, thank you, thank you, thank you. You guys have been a great support. You guys have been there with us throughout the journey as well. And I do not take your support of the youth for granted either. So I do appreciate you all as well. Thank you all so much for joining us this morning. And that is the end of our ceremony.
All right, again, thank you. That is the conclusion of today's event. We look forward to having you next year. For those of you that are heading back to high school, I encourage you to do something. You know, make good grades, accomplish something. For those of you that are headed off to college, go to class, learn something, meet people, start planning your future today. And would like to also thank Adarius for all of his hard work. He's our new athletic specialist, but he started in prevention and we truly appreciate him. But to my young people, the sky's the limit. Don't take for granted this opportunity that you have, no matter who you are, where you're from, what your background is. There's nothing stopping you from being the best that you can be but you. I mean that, we stand here for you, to support you, but you gotta believe in yourself. Sometimes it's gonna get hard, and sometimes you're not gonna know what all the answers are, but it's okay. You have a new support system, and all of these individuals that are here, including myself, but I encourage you, do something. Nothing comes to a dreamer but a dream. So step up, step out. I always say this, lead, follow, or just get out of the way. But you gotta do something. You gotta do something. So with that, have a wonderful morning. Can't wait to see some of y'all come back next summer. Next summer, some of y'all gonna come back and you'll be in the program, but some of y'all gonna come back and be city employees. I see it every year. So this isn't goodbye. This is see you later.